Hi, my name is Anupriya. In this session, we will talk about one of the very important part of the body language, which is eye contact. Maintaining an eye contact with the partner you are sharing your thought is very important because it is considered a non-verbal communication tool. There are few rules that we follow, or there are few rules that are very important to keep in your mind when you meet with someone and when you focus on your speech to deliver. So by following such kind of rules, definitely you can keep the rapport of, or you can maintain the rapport of proper eye contact well. So let's go towards this rule and try to understand that how it can help us. First one, use 50% or 70% rule. What is this 50% or 70%? When you are speaking, when you are sharing your thoughts to your partner, alright, so it is your turn now to look at him more, alright. It means half of the time of the conversation, it is your job to maintain an eye contact with your partner, alright. Because it is your job, your turn that you are trying to convince with your message to the listener. But once it is your time to listen the contact, what your partner is sharing with you, so 70% you can maintain an eye contact, because probably you get engaged in writing the content he is sharing with you, or you are not very much, you know, into the topic, so you can rest your lid, you can get slow with your eyes. So during the time of listening the contact, what you can do, 70% you can avoid the eye contact. So this works, and it is considered that it is the great manner of maintaining your eye contact with your partner. Next one is maintain it initial for 4 to 5 seconds. When you meet with someone at the first time, or it is not the first time, you just meet with someone, you exchange the greetings, you give your introduction, and you receive, you are busy in receiving the introduction of the other person. So initial stage and at the beginning, it is very important to look at him for 4 to 5 seconds, because it compels you to wear a beautiful smile on the face, and it proves that this meeting is going to be fruitful. So when the beginning is good, definitely the whole context and the whole meeting is going to give you something very nice. So initial of the meeting, maintain 4 to 5 minute eye contact with your partner. What is next? Don't mirror your partner. It means don't try to copy your partner. If he is looking at you, what you did, you suddenly look at him. If he looked away, you distracted with the looks of it. Don't do it. It means that what you consider with the word eye contact. Do you match your eyes to eyes? Do you peep out in others' eyes? No. If you are having a conversation with your partner, so you maintain a distance. You don't fall on each other's face. So once you maintain a distance and you are focusing on maintaining a proper eye contact, so what happens? Definitely gazing at someone or staring at someone gives you a very bad expression. So do one thing, you just distract your eyes on his nose or cheeks or forehead or any other part of the face. It will be also considered that you are maintaining an eye contact, but it should happen only for a moment, not for the long. Otherwise, it is assumed that you are not paying proper attention towards the content what he is speaking with you. So don't copy your partner. It is a bad rule during a communication. Don't roll around your eyes. I have observed all the men out there, especially, that when there is a communication going on, what the people do, they just up and down, and they look in this way. It shows that you are investigating others' body, and it is very awkward, and especially when it is a meeting, when it is a formal meeting, this rule is a sin. Alright, so don't roll around your eyes. It means that don't distract your eyes in this manner. It is good that you started good, you maintained a proper eye contact for 4 to 5 minutes, and the conversation went on. But during the conversation, when you are doing this, it means that you are not such a good person. Last one, not too much, not too less. You have been taught that maintaining an eye contact is a very important tool. Alright, to give you a good impression. But once you have learned this content that maintain an eye contact, what do you did? You met with the person whom you have to exchange your thoughts, and you're just staring at him, you're gazing at him, because you're conscious that I have to maintain an eye contact. I have to match my eyes with others' one. Alright, so it shows that you are very aggressive. It shows that you are very much, your body language is very much conscious, and it proves that you are here only to focus on your eye contact and nothing else. And you lose all your content in your mind that you are here to discuss. So doing this excess, doing this too much is not a good one. But when you maintain a less eye contact, I am talking to you but I'm not looking at you. What do you think about me? What kind of person I am? You didn't like me in behaving in such way, alright? Because my eye contact was less. So when you maintain a less eye contact with your partner, it proves that you are not a trustworthy person. You are not taking interest what the conversation is going on, alright? Or you are a very careless person. It all these bad traits are given to you. So avoiding these bad traits, you have to maintain a worthy eye contact and average eye contact. So by following these rules, you can at least maintain a good eye contact. I don't say you that force yourself. You have got these points and just force yourself, because again you will become very conscious. Your mind is smart enough. Keep all these clues somewhere fixed in your mind, and at the time of the right behavior, your face or your eyes will become or you start behaving in such manner. So do follow this. Bye.